Hello friends, this is Professor Tushar Ogle, working as Assistant Professor, Department of Agriculture and Technology, KK Wark College of Agriculture, Nasik. Today, I am here to present my lecture on the topic Mass Production of Trichogamma. Trichogamma is a potential parasitoid which is used in agriculture from last many years. Trichogamma species is the category of true egg parasitoid identified by all the previous scientists and workers in the field biological control. Trichogamma species is the most widely used biocontrol agent in the world. It's effective against the all bollworm complex in cotton, sugar cane, most of the Lepidopteran pest. It offers low cost control over the pest with effective plant protection option, as in it is a major in component of IPM. It includes two major species is being used. It is the Trichogramma chirulinis, Trichogramma japonicum. Trichogramma are the wasp-like structure having a dark color, tiny structure, and female wasp lays about 20 to 40 eggs into the host eggs. The entire life cycle is completed within 8 to 10 days. The tiny wasp search its host or its pest eggs in the feed and laying the eggs into the eggs of the pest. This is the scientist Charles B. Riley, C.B. Riley, is the founder or the scientist who worked first time description of the Trichogramma species in the world in 1871. He described the tiny species of Trichogramma minutum. After that, he also described the Trichogramma perisodium. Various species is also evolved by the scientist. Currently, that all over the world, Trichogramma species is about 200. But as of 1960, only some of 40 species has been described for the use in agriculture as a pest management. Biology of Trichogramma. The development of all Trichogramma species is very similar, as they all are the hymenopterans. Being an egg parasite, the female drills by making the hole through its ovipositor, sharp pointed ovipositor, to the corian. Corian is the outer egg cover, and deposits its egg within the egg of the host egg. Large females parasitize more eggs than the smaller female, as they have the capacity to lay more eggs than the normal female. The life cycle is completed within 8 to 10 days, but if may prolong in the lower temperature. During the low temperature, the life cycle is restricted. And again, some stages required one or more days, so it may be extended to 12 or 15 days. This is the life cycle of the Trichogramma species. The female lays egg within the recently laid host eggs, fresh eggs. As the wasp larvae develops, the host egg turns to the blackish because it secretes urate crystals by which it colored changed to the blackish. Each female parasitizes about 100 eggs in its entire life cycle or entire period of egg laying. It may also destroy additional eggs by the host feeding. The short life cycle, about 8 to 10 days, sometimes it may long to 12 or 15 days. It's helped to increase the Trichogramma population rapidly in the field. This picture is showing a female lays egg in the caterpillar moth eggs by drilling its corian. The larvae after this Trichogramma is developed and inside the egg corian, and the egg turns to the blackish color. Again, the adult is emerged out, and hence the life cycle is completed this way with 8 to 10 days. This is a particular passion of egg laying by the Ichneumonida wasp. The Ichneumonid wasp is a structure having the longer ovipositor, which like needle-like structure. It can lay egg inside the stem for the against the host larvae, like wood borer or stem borer. But in the case of Trichogramma having very short ovipositor, here it is possible to only lay egg by sitting down on the host egg with the help of the ovipositor. This is some difference between the same order of the Ichneumonid and Trichogramma species. Scientific classification of Trichogramma: Kingdom Animalia, phylum Arthropoda, क्लास इंसेक्टा, ऑर्डर हाइमनोप्टेरा, सब ऑर्डर एपोक्रिटा, सुपर फैमिली जलसिडी, फैमिली ट्राइकोरामेटिडी एंड जीनस ट्राइकोरामा. ड्यूरिंग दी रिसर्च देर आर डिफरेंट स्पीसीज इज आइडेंटिफाइड, डिफरेंट स्पीसीज आर आइडेंटिफाइड फॉर द ऑफ द ट्राइकोरामा वेयर ट्राइकोरामा चिलोनिस, ट्राइकोरामा जापानिकम, ट्राइकोरामा बैक्ट्री. दीज आर सम कॉमन स्पीसीज बींग यूज नाउडेज इन द पेस्ट मैनेजमेंट. These three species are very majorly popularly used in agriculture. The Trichoderma chilonis is very famous for the all kinds of Lepidoptera paste in sugarcane, cotton, other vegetables. Trichoderma japonicum is very popular used in rice ecosystem, where the Trichoderma bacteria is very popular to being used against the pink bollworm from last 2 to 3 years. The Trichoderma chilonis having some characters like it is an important egg parasitoid in the history. Lepidopteran paste which effectively control mostly sugarcane stem borer complex, cotton borer complex, even the Helicoverpa majora as a fruit borer or pod borer in pulses and vegetables is also getting control effectively with the help of the Trichoderma chilonis. Trichoderma chilonis having a short ovipositor than the Trichoderma japonicum. It can be more effective when its parasitic potential searching ability is well adapted in the field, and mostly the sugarcane industry is getting much benefit with the help of this Trichoderma chilonis. This is the Trichoderma japonicum. It is the all over as accepted by the all the host of the eggs for the parasitization, but it having the longer ovipositor than the Trichoderma chilonis, hence it is very suitably used against the rice stem borer as it having the longer ovipositor. Trichoderma japonicum having longer ovipositor which able to penetrate the scale covering over the rice stem borer eggs, hence the chilonis is not suitable in the field of rice for the control of the stem borer. Trichoderma bacteria recently improved in Australia. It having great capacity of control against the pink bollworm, that is the Pectinophora gassipiella. Many Trichoderma species have been observed to develop through this larval instars, but Trichoderma bacteria develops through only two instar. Nowadays it is being widely used in India against the pink bollworm. This is some paste which is targeted by Trichoderma. We can obtain 100% control against this pest. That is the sugarcane internal borer, Saccharifuga indicus, early shoot borer, Geranium catulus. This is top shoot borer, Scubophaga aegyptalis, American bollworm in cotton, Helicoverpa majora, Clonophora gassipiella. This is the urea species, urea vitella, urea insulina are the more main common species of the cotton. Again the rice paddy stem borer which is controlled by the japonicum species, Helicoverpa majora in the pod borer, fruit borer, even imbringer, the very dangerous pest that is the Lucernus arbonus is also get effectively controlled with the help of the Trichoderma. Then we will see the why should we should use the Trichoderma in for the pest management. As we had discussed earlier, the Trichoderma having the great capacity to parasitize eggs at much extent, and it is a major target having the target of Lepidopteran paste all over the world in all over the crop ecosystem. The use of Trichoderma reduce the chemical spraying and preserve predator and natural enemy in their particular crop system. Even it promotes the use of some biological predator parasite biopesticide in the field. They can establish well in tropical agrosystem. Even they can integrated be easily with other control measure like chemical, biological, physical, mechanical methods. Even this is the cheapest method, and mass raising can be we can minimize the cost of production in the preparation of the trichopod at commercial level, as it requires very few technical things during its production. Today the scope for the commercial production of the biogens is having very great scope. As we consider the data from the government agency, about 140 biocontrol agents which producing the different biogens and biopesticide is still established in India. They are able to meet demand only less than 1% of the crop area along across the India. production and marketing of trichoderma viridi against few fungal diseases and trichoderma against the sugarcane early shoot borer has been started in India. Mostly these two bioagent and biopesticide production, trichoderma viridi is a fungus which is used against the soil-borne diseases, and trichoderma is majorly parasitized, is against the lepidopteran pest. Majorly these two types of bioagents is being produced on the most of the sugarcane industry in all over India. Various SAU, State Agriculture Institute, also producing these two major bioagents in agriculture. Even the trichoderma research accelerated the development of industry and entomology. Even we can start again before the innovation of the BT cotton. All over the Maharashtra, even across the India, there are some small scale industries which produces the trichocot, but recent from last 10 years it was vanished again with the attack of this pink bollworm, Pectinopora gossypii. Again the need of the trichocot is being increased. Mastering of trichoderma chirinis involves the various things and some host also. We will see the one by one. Trichoderma chirinis is an indigenous parasite for the various Lepidopteran tissue borers. Hence, we need again Lepidopterous host for the laboratory for its multiplication. It requires the laboratory host as it is obligate. It requires the production. It requires the host, Lepidopteran host for the production. Scientists tested more host for the mass production of this trichoderma chirinis. Rice moth, that is the Corsair cephalic, as a major host. Angiomyomas green moth are the some identified factitious host for the multiplication of the trichoderma species. Factitious host means it is suitable host which is very easy to multiply in laboratory, even it is very cost effective host, is identified like the rice moth. Even some scientists have worked on the eggs of the eerie silkworm, that is Semia scythia ricini, which is successfully possible to rare trichoderma species. Even National Bureau of Agriculture Important Insect Resources at Bangalore, they also tried the eggs of the eerie silkworm for rearing of the trichoderma chirinis. As these eggs of the eerie silkworm having very bigger size than the Corsaira, it is very easy to lay more eggs within a short period of time. This is the rearing room, Corsaira cephalonica. Corsaira cephalonica rearing methodology, it will take more time. We can discuss in the another lecture. This is type of structure is available in many production units. This is the Corsaira rearing boxes having the rearing of the Corsaira. After that, the eggs were collected for the several functions like mating, sieving of the eggs. Again, we have to store the fresh eggs separately. We require the material like egg card, pre-printed trago card on the card sheet, Corsaira eggs, fresh Corsaira eggs will require, gum arabica is required, camel hair brush for the pasting of the gum. The sieve for the even distribution of the eggs on the card, refrigerator required to store, plastic bottles, plastic vials, other plastic vessels are required. UV cabinet is required for the make sterilization of the eggs which is sticked up on the trichocard. This is the flowchart. First of all, measure the 1 cc eggs. 1 cc is equal to 18 to 20,000 eggs approximately. Fill the information on the backside of the cards by putting the name of the species which will be going to charge, means inoculate. For example, Trichoderma chirinis or Trichoderma japonica or Trichoderma bacteria. Even we have to write the probable date of the emergence behind the card, because when we are giving it to the farmer should know the probable date of release. Gum is applied on the cards, pass the Corsaira eggs on the trichocard, paste the Corsaira eggs on the trichocard by using the sieves. Even with the help of the sieve, we can easily put or easily paste the card Corsaira eggs in even distribution over the card. Expose the trichocard for 30 minutes to ultraviolet radiation in the UV cabinet. Due to this exposure to UV light, it destroys all the embryo of the eggs by exposing to the UV light. It is helpful to kill the embryo, kill the living part of the egg, which favors directly to for the feeding of our trichorama larvae. It is created for the to prevent the emergence of these host larvae before the completion of the life cycle of the trichorama. Again, next to after the exposing to the UV light, make the mating chamber with the help of some PET jar or PET bottle, plastic bottle. Put two strip of parasitized eggs, already parasitized eggs as a culture in each bottle. Make a ratio of 1:6 for the inoculation. One card is required for to inoculate six trico cards. Put the name, date of inoculation, name of species on the mating jar. After that, trichorama will grow or will develop, emerge out from the parasitized eggs card and directly start eagling over the Coursera eggs. The color of eggs changes to blackish due to secretion of the urate crystal through the ovipositor. Again, when the color changes to whitish to blackish, then make packaging, suitable packaging of trico cards in the polythene bag, and keep these cards for the storage in the refrigerator at 5 degrees Celsius. This is the procedure, pasting of gum, measuring of the eggs. This is the sieving of the eggs for the even distribution. This is the mating chamber with the well labeled label of the species, date of inoculation. This is overall material required for rearing. This is the photograph showing these different important instructions written in the trico card. Here, the local language, we should use the local language to disseminate the information about the how to use, when to use, in recommended crops. Here, the recommended crops is written, number of cards to be distributed along the all over the field is written, name of manufacturer, the product and the brand name. This is the backside of the card where we are actually sticking the eggs of Coursera. This is the pictorial presentation of the trico card preparation. It is the methodology developed by the NIPHM. The rearing of the Coursera is required sorghum. This is the Coursera rearing facility. We will get the eggs, fresh eggs from this method. Again, we are going to the spreading of the eggs, UV exposure. Again, we will getting the parasitization in the small tubes or the inoculation chamber by these plastic vials or plastic jars. Again, the life cycle is continuously going on. How to use trico card in the field? Read the instructions on the card written as for the date concern. We should follow the date of expected release. First, cut the card breadth wise along the middle cross line into the equal strip. Then make a small segment along with the marking as per the requirement. One card gives 20 segments. We have to use the stapler for two segments in a plant. If it is in cotton, or one segment in a per plant in other crops like vegetables. Other crops like sugarcane, even some dense crop required to staple at lower side, and it should not be exposed directly to sunlight. We have to maintain the distance between two strips. It is about 10 by 10 meter distance. The individual card size is about 17.05 centimeter by 14 centimeter. But strip size is 5 cm to 1.75 cm. So we have to make 20 strips from each card and we have to distribute it in the field at a 10 meter distance. How this pest actually get killed with this tiny wasp? This tiny adult of parasitic serves host eggs in the field and parasitize them by laying their eggs within the eggs of the pest. The parasitized larvae feed on the embryonic content of the pest eggs and complete the development inside the host eggs. The parasitized eggs turn black into 3 to 4 days and parasite emerge after the 7 to 8 days. Within a 10 or 12 days, the life cycle is get completed and again the emerge out adult again search for the new host. Advantages of using the tarot cards: less cost effective is a major concern. It requires very few amount as compared to the chemical pesticide. Field application or field release is very simple as compared to the other method. No technical material required, no extra technical assistance required for the release. Record of shows the higher yield of sugar can about 4 to 5 tons as secondary infestation is avoided while using this tarot card. In actually noticed by the different sugar cane factories across the India. Cost of pest control is very minimum, and it is a very safe method, that is, it never causes environmental pollution or chemical residue issue in the field. Rate of application of trichograma, it should be depend on the recommendations given by the manufacturer, as we have to return back side of the card. 40,000 to 50,000 parasitized eggs should be released per time, per unit time, per hectare. Means 3 to 4 trichocardia should be recommended, should be released per hectare. 2 to 3 trichocardia can be released per acre for the pest management. These are some examples which is received from the internet. The other companies having this kind of the material, which is having very attractive packing with this strip having the hole. We have to just tear one from one side, and we have to just hang in the crops. In this country, foreign country, they have different host, different species for the rearing of the different crops. Like this, which is different species in the fruit, different species in the other crops. So they have some applied some other technical things, which is very useful for the dissemination of this kind of the truck cards. In even this kind of the same companies production, giving the production of this for the fruits. This is for the maize and corn. Again, this is another method to hang up the trichograma card in tomato. This is our Indian method. In trichograma japonicum is release in the field with the help of this inverted glass, plastic glass, which is disposable glass. It prevents the damage of the cards from the direct sunlight or direct rain shower. It is mainly for the japonicum species in the trichograma. Even some foreign countries having developed some technology that directly, without using the card, directly it drops or it disseminated the parasitized eggs of the trichograma through the drone system or drone equipment. It is very helpful to cover maximum area in a very short period of time. This is the day to day development from one single day to 10th day. Here the journey started from the day first. Slowly the color of is getting changes, and at day 4 it turns to the blackish, and at the 10th day it emerges out as an adult from the blackened eggs. This is a diagrammatic view of parasitization, where it starts from the landing over the egg surface and laying the eggs inside the corian by drilling through the ovipositor. Larvae develops inside the host egg. It forms the pupa. After the pupation, it emerges out as an adult from the parasitized eggs. Precautions should be taken while in application of this trichograma. We should pack the trichocard that the parasitized surface, or it should not be exposed outside. It should be at inner side. If we are carrying two cards, then this should be face to face with the parasitized surface. It should not be exposed to light, because direct sunlight or the exposure to the radiation is also may damage to some extent. Emergence date should be written at specified place at the county card. Guidance of the farmers and guidelines should be written there. Tiger card should be stapled at inner side of the leaf to avoid direct sunlight exposure. Farmers should remain using the pesticides before and after the trichograma release. At it requires only 10 days for the completing life cycle, so we can stop the chemicals for 10 to 15 days. even you have to maintain some humidity by irrigating or giving the flood irrigation to the field to favor the development of the Trachoma chironis. This is the actual method we follow in India to staple the card at lower side of sugar cane, or this is the cabbage crop. Here the stapling method is used for at the, that is the trap crop, the sunflower. This kind of release method can be developed in the field for the effective control of the reproductive rampage. Even in sugarcane, cotton, we are directly going to staple this parasitized card strip to the lower side of the leaf. This is all about the use of the Traco cards in the field for the management of the reproductive rampage. Thank you. If you have any inquiry, you can contact me for this Trachoma production. This video is prepared for only student purpose. This is not meant for any kind of commercial interest. Thank you.